Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how you can add an image to a Jasper report using Java and NetBeans. In my previous tutorial, I have shown you how you could copy my SQL to Jasper report and create a report like this one. Here. Now suppose that you have received another new requirement to add the logo somewhere here in your reports. How will you achieve that? Without a further ado, let us start and create. Create our logo. We fill it with a color, and on top of that we write a small text abc.com. abc.com, and here we are going to save it as PNG and we locate it somewhere here under this directory. We call it here my logo. Here is my logo that we just saved, and we come here and delete whatever we had before. Then the next thing now is come to our report here, come here and create a new folder. We call it img. And inside that report, we are going to paste our logo, newly created logo. Here is the one here. So we just copy that one here and paste it. We have our logo. Now, the next thing that we have to do now is to track image folder, and from where do you want to get it? From a resource, from Jasper server URL, absolute path, no custom expression. Now here you want to get it from the workspace, and here we browse. Here you can see automatically we have it already come this under this folder img that we have just created. If it was not there, then you have to browse it. Then we can select it. Then we have a preview, and bam, we have our logo. Now if we preview it again, you have our logo here. Now if you just continue in the same fashions and increase the height of the row in order to have many pages, you can see we have 3 pages now. If you go to the next, we don't have the logo here. Page 3, no logo is there. So if you want this logo to appear in many pages, what we are going to do is, instead of adding that one in the title, we drag it and put it in the page header instead. We have it in the page header, we save it, and now if you go in page 2, you can see that the logo is appearing in all pages. So that is it, it is ready. Now what we have to do now is if you want, we edit it here, is to go to this edit here, or we just save it. And instead, go to the directory where our Jasper report is located under users, my name, and Jasper workspace. Here report is US report number 3. We just copy it and bring it to a different locations here where you want our source code to access it. Now if you go to NetBeans, here is our code that we have created before. Here is the connections to the database and the credentials and the location to our Jasper report. So here we call the name is Jasper report version 3. Here is the location where it's located. Here you are just referring to that location, and the PDF name that you want to get is 3. Then in the code, as I explained in the other tutorial before this one that you can see in my playlist, here we load the JR PDF and then compile it, fill it, then export it. So this one are optional, like we may just avoid like compiling this file by taking directly this file from Jasper report and starting our execution, starting our code from filling just without compiling here to make it faster, but that's not the case here. So it is there. Now the main question is, where are we going to locate our image here in NetBeans? So what we do now is we right click the project again, create a new folder, and in this time now we are going to browse under src. Under src here we are going to create one img folder. We have the img folder. Now what we do now is we take our image and we go to a directory where of our project folder. Here is the img folder that we have just created under the src, and then we locate it there. Then the next thing that we have to be aware is that we will have to edit again our report. We just go to Notepad++, and if we come down, here is the location of our image. This slash here, forward slash here, is for Linux. As you are using Windows, to be careful with, so we have to refer as src first. If you were using Linux, we keep it this way, but because we use Windows, we are going to add some backslash like this way. We have to return this step here, is very important. So after editing and setting the path to backslash, double backslash, and adding the reference to the src folder, now our report is almost ready. What we do now is we go to NetBeans, then run our project and see how we behave. It loads, compile, fill parameters, and then execute, export the Jasper to PDF. Now let's go to the locations here. Here is the locations where we initially save. It was here. Jasper report 3 is the newly created file. You can see, bam, you have our logo which is out. So I hope that this small tutorial on Jasper report and image has been useful to you. This was one way of adding the static image statically to the Jasper report. In the next teacher tutorial, I will try to make this one by taking some image information from the database to make it more dynamic. I hope that you like it. And if you are interested, don't forget to subscribe yourself to my channel in order not to miss the next episode. I will also add the description, the link to the code snippet used in this tutorial under the description that you will find in this video. Stay tuned. Bye.